Welcome to the Dog Solid channel, and today we are going to go over a comprehensive dog breed review video on the Spanish Mastiff. Make sure to watch all the way to the end of this video to make sure that this massive dog breed is the perfect dog for you. There are many different traits that can describe the Spanish Mastiff, such as great size, well-balanced, very powerful, and muscular. These guard dogs come with massive heads and their bodies are covered with a medium-length coat. They are also known for their ferocious bark, which is low-pitched and deep, very sonorous and audible from a considerable distance. This breed was primarily used for guarding and defense, and herding livestock during the Middle Ages. Other names that the Spanish Mastiff go by are Mastín Español de Campo y Trabajo, Mastín Gadanero, Mastín Leones, Mastín Extremeño. Well, without further ado, let's jump into this video about the Spanish Mastiff. History. The Spanish Mastiff originated in the Spanish territories of Asturias, Cantabria, Province of León, and Province of Zamora. It is an old breed with records tracing its history over 2,000 years ago. It is speculated the Mastiffs were introduced by the Greeks and Phoenicians before the Roman invasion, as they were mentioned in writing, first appearing from the Iberian Peninsula. Europe was known for using these massive dogs for herding, transporting, and protecting the merino livestock. The white color allowed the Europeans to distinguish the Spanish Mastiff from wolves they were guarding their flock from. It is also believed that the Spaniards used this breed in battles against the native people they conquered. The Europeans have a strong admiration for this breed, as they can withstand climate changes and harsh conditions, and are a very independent dog with strong defense instincts, which we will discuss later on. Appearance. Stocky and rustic looking describes the general appearance of the Spanish Mastiff. It is very massive with a very large chest and the power of a monster truck. The Spanish Mastiff has a strong bone structure and a muscular rectangular body. As stated earlier, the Mastiff's has a well-pronounced, massive head with a deep muzzle, strong jaws, full lips, and a characteristic dewlap on the neck, showing clearly his Mastiff type. Spanish Mastiff hind feet are equipped with double dew claws. Their eyes are smaller than the average large dog breed and are relaxed. The tail is fringed and carried low. Although a very heavy breed, its movement is to be free and flexible. There are two variant types of the Spanish Mastiff. The first type is known as Mastín Pesado, which means heavy Mastiff, and the second type is called Mastín Ligero, which means light Mastiff. The heavier Mastín Pesado is known to be used in dog shows for their amazing features, such as its much bigger head, more bone mass, more loose skin, and can weigh well over 200 pounds. The lighter Mastiffs are more agile and athletic and are more common in the Meseta and Andalusia in the south of Spain. These two are breeds not considered their own, but rather different variants of the Spanish Mastiff. The two types often interbreed. Coat appearance and colors. The coats of the Spanish Mastiff are dense, thick, medium length, smooth, distributed all over the body. Their coats help protect them from extreme weather conditions. It's important for the Spanish Mastiff to have access to shade and water if they're outside in very hot temperatures. They can come in the following colors of yellow, fawn, red, black, wolf color, deer color. And they can also come in combined colors like brindle, particolored. Size and weight. As stated many times, this is a giant size breed and the weight can vary among both males and females. The height of this massive breed is 28.5 inches at minimum for females, and the males can grow 30.5 inches at minimum. For the weight, the female can easily weigh between 145 and 170 pounds, and the males can weigh between 185 pounds to 220 pounds plus. Research has shown that the Spanish Mastiffs seem to have changed drastically in size over the past 30 years or so, with both female and the male having a less impressive stature than they do now. The drastic increase in height and weight may be due to the fact that these dogs are now used more as show dogs instead of the working dogs where they needed to be much smaller and agile. Personality. This breed is dubbed the Gentle Giant and is very intelligent. The Spanish Mastiff is affectionate, kind, and noble, and never afraid to face off with dangerous animals or strangers, especially when defending its cattle, family, or farm. The dog is self-confident as it is aware of its enormous power. Even though these dogs are massive, they love to play with children. Due to their large size, it is a must that you supervise them when interacting with small children, as they can accidentally cause injury. These dogs will form strong bonds with their family. It is a toss-up when it comes to whether or not these dogs can coexist with other animals. Some owners claim that the Spanish Mastiff can become territorial and not want to have another dog and might show some aggression towards cats and other smaller animals. All of this could be potentially avoided if you socialize the pup at an early age. With that being said, it may be for the best to have your Spanish Mastiff as the only pet in the household. Living conditions. Due to the Spanish Mastiff being large in nature, it is not suitable for apartment life, but it could possibly work if you plan to be very consistent with your pack walks, which would put the dog in a rest mode for most of the day. These dogs become inactive and restless when left indoors and should at least have a large yard to run and play in. This dog's thick coat protects it from cold and wet so it can live outdoors. Exercise and upkeep. When fully mature, this breed has an average need for exercise. Like all giant dogs, this breed is very slow to mature, especially the males, which keep growing up until 2.5 to 4 years of age and are rather short-lived. They have a fairly low activity level and need only a moderate amount of exercise. Daily walks for about an hour or twice a day is about all they need. They tend to be most active when they are young adults. This is not a breed for very active, sporty people who want a dog to jog, run alongside a bike, or play fetch or frisbee with. Training. Don't be misled by their good-natured look. The Spanish Mastiff is a guard dog that guards the cattle, and its presence is vital in the absence of the shepherd. When the Spanish Mastiff receives orders, just as with the St. Bernards and Molossoid breeds, it is usually very stubborn and tends to go and do their own thing. The training has to be done with patience, firmness, and understanding. It is necessary to start as soon as possible, and in most cases, 6 months of age is a good point. Health. The Spanish Mastiff breed is predisposed to many of the same health issues that all large and giant dog breeds suffer from. While most are generally healthy, some may be prone to a very common health issues, which is why it is very important to maintain good care and regular veterinarian checkups. Some of the more common problems Spanish Mastiffs suffer from include bloat, hip knee dysplasia, entropion eye, panostitis, called growing pains that affects young, giant dog breeds who grow too quickly. Grooming. The Spanish Mastiff has shorter hair than a lot of other livestock guardian dog breeds, and therefore does require less grooming than some. However, the dogs do still require weekly brushing, and they do shed a lot during the fall, and even more so during their spring blowout. The blowout is when they shed their undercoats in preparation for changes in temperature. As far as a Spanish Mastiff's weekly grooming goes, you will need to use a pin brush and a metal comb. During periods of high shedding, you will likely want to use a de-shedding brush. Spanish Mastiffs will also need occasional ear cleanings and possibly nail trimmings. Some working dogs may wear down their nails in the field instead. Perhaps one of the most noticeable traits of the Spanish Mastiff to pet owners is that these dogs are huge droolers. The dogs will especially drool after exertion, eating, or drinking. Some owners have suggested that if you let these dogs in the house, you may want to keep drool rags readily available. I suggest leather or faux leather couches and armchairs. These are much easier to wipe off and dry than cloth fabrics. Nutrition and diet. An ideal Spanish Mastiff diet should be formulated for a giant dog breed with a medium amount of energy. They may try to eat too quickly or overeat, so you should stick to a regular feeding schedule and have smaller meals throughout the day instead of 2 or 3 large meals. Limit their amount of treats as well. As with all dogs, the Spanish Mastiff's dietary needs will change from puppyhood to adulthood and will continue to change into their senior years. You should ask your veterinarian for recommendations about your Spanish Mastiff's diet, as there is far too much variation among individual dogs, including weight, energy, and health, to make a specific recommendation. Cost. The price of a Spanish Mastiff puppy can range quite dramatically. If you want a purebred Spanish Mastiff puppy, prices begin around $1,000 US and go up to $1,500. Even then, there can be some breeders that ask for way more, especially if the parents are show or champion dogs. Also, if the breeder has gotten the puppy registered, shots, or even microchipped can add to the price of the puppy. Make sure you look below at our reputable breeders to get a dog you know will be healthy and happy. This would not be an ultimate owner's guide if we did not talk about some of the disadvantages and cons that you might experience if you decide to own the Spanish Mastiff. The Spanish Mastiff may not be the right dog for you if you don't want to deal with the following. Droolings. Matures very slowly. Extremely large dog. Extensive training. Requires a lot of exercise. Can be accidentally harmful around toddlers and very small children. It's highly recommended before deciding whether the Mastiff is the right dog for you that you do plenty of research by watching multiple videos and reading different articles. Talk to other Spanish Mastiff owners, reputable breeders, and rescue groups to learn more. Don't be upset if the massive dog does not fit your lifestyle, as there's a whole world of dog breeds out there. With a little research, you can find the right one to bring home. If you're interested in similar breeds of the Neapolitan Mastiff, Pyrenean Mastiff, Tibetan Mastiff, Bull Mastiff, or Dogue de Bordeaux, look into these similar breeds to compare the pros and cons. Well, that wraps up the video. If you have any interesting facts about the Spanish Mastiff, please feel free to share it in the comments section. Thank you for watching this video and check out my other playlist on large dog breeds and other videos about different dog breeds. The link is below in the description. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the Dog Solid channel. And I will see you in the next video.